So here's our table of data. We have obviously four different columns. We're going to want to search the vendor column. So what we're going to imagine is that we're auditing this list of transactions, and you want to look for certain last names, but they might be in the text somewhere. So let's come down to something that we'll be looking for. We want to see this last name, K-I-E-H-N. You have some suspicions about transactions with this person, but they're buried in the text. So he exists on line 10, but this last name is also on line 17. And we're going to end up just highlighting those and not hiding anything. So let's come over into cell E2. And what we're going to be using, believe it or not, is a function called search. So let's type that in. And this is going to return the position of the characters that you type in the text. So if it's the fifth letter, it's going to return a 5. If it doesn't find it though, it's not going to return anything. So we're going to keep that in mind as we work around this. If you want it case sensitive, you have to use the function called find. So just remember that, just swap that out and do everything else the same. That should be fine. So, but when you're doing search, if I type the parentheses, it's going to give me the text and it's giving me a hint. It says, what do you want me to search for? So in this case, let's just type in a string that we know is in there. So I'll start with a quote and I'll type in K-U-L-A-S. I see that in C3 right now. Okay. Now, and I won't do the case right just to show you. All right, close that off, do a comma, and then it's asking the text to search. So it's asking for a range of where to look. And we'll give it C2 because that's where we want to search. We can only do this one at a time before we put it in conditional formatting. And we hit enter and it just returns value. It's a value error because it says I can't find anything. But let's drag this down into all of these other cells. And what you'll notice is it returned a 6 for row 3 because that's the only row that has the K-U-L-A-S. So that's just a way to show you how this search function works. It returns an error if it doesn't find what you type, and it returns a value if you do type something that you're looking for. So let's get rid of this. That was just a little proof of concept, and we're going to build a conditional formatting formula for it. In the conditional formatting, we're going to want to make an input box where you can type, and the conditional formatting rule will look inside that box. So let's just label this search box. Not very original. Well, where you type it in, we'll give it a little bit of highlighting just to indicate that it's an input field. And we'll leave this as it is for now, and we'll come over and build our conditional formatting rule. So to make it easier, let's just highlight each entire column. We're going to want to format the entire row, not just the cell in column C, just to make it look nicer. So we'll go A, B, C, D. And if you grab the columns like this from the top, it'll grab the entire column, so all the way down to the bottom. And you would go to format, conditional formatting. I happen to have already clicked that. So if you look on the right-hand side, the window is up here for me, conditional formatting rules. And I'll left-click on add another rule. All right, so the apply to range is filled out A1 to D1003. I really don't need the header. Let's just change that just for have this a little bit more proper. And what we want to do, we want to format the cells if the search function returns something greater than a 0, right? And that's not a built-in function. So you do have text contains. So you can use that if you want, and you won't need the search box. But then you won't have a search box, so you'll have to go back into this formula every time if you want to change the words. So that's just for a different application. So let's come down to custom formula is, and that just gives us an input box. It's waiting for a formula, so we're going to use that search function that we just tested out a minute ago, but we're going to customize it a little bit. So we will hit enter to let Sheets know that we're going to type in a formula. The box is red right now because the formula is not done. Okay, so we're telling it we're using the search function. All right, so the search function, the first value that it wants is what to search for. And every time, this is a trick, you have to get these dollar signs in here because we need to use a fixed reference. Every time, no matter where it is, even though right now it's in A2, we want it to look at F3. no matter what. So we put the dollar signs before the F and before the 3 because we wanted to fix the column and row reference. The next value that it wants is where to search. So each row, we only want it to search column C in that row. So for A2, we want it to highlight if this works when it looks at C2. So we're going to fix the C and then type a 2, but don't fix the 2 because we want that to be able to shift down on the next row. So let's close that off. Our search function is done, but we want this highlighted if the search function returns a number, right? So we'll just say greater than 0. And it's giving you a false return right now because nothing's in the search box. So it's actually finding the string of nothing. We'll hit done, and let's come over to this search box and give it a try. So we'll type ABBOT, hit enter, and there you go. So it found Abbott. So we'll act like you're an auditor and you wanted to use this because you wanted to highlight, let's say one of the owners of the corporation's last name is K-I-E-H-N. And you think that they might have set up some fake vendors in here. So let's go ahead and type K-I-E-H-N and hit enter. And it highlights 3 transactions, but they're all different, but they have that string somewhere in their name. So it's still showing the rest of the list, but then you can use this to focus in on a couple of the transactions that you want to look at. All right, so now let's apply your conditional formatting knowledge to building an interactive checklist. So every task that you check off, it's going to cross it off and highlight the entire row kind of in a gray to make it look like it's gone away. So I'll see you in that video. Thanks.